Hello students, I am an aptitude trainer from Department of Career Planning and Development, and today we are going to discuss the topic data interpretation. And in data interpretation we are going to discuss two type of questions, two type of graphs, which are a line graph and a bar graph. So let's see the thing. First of all, for data interpretation you need to know four chapters. The chapters are, the chapter number one, you need to know the average, how to calculate the average of the numbers, then the percentage, then a ratio and approximation. You need to know the these chapters before going to further the questions of data interpretation. Okay, let's see. For data interpretation, everything and every information is given in the question. You have to just analyze the things, you have to identify with how to apply the given information in the given questions. Okay, let's see some line graph questions. Okay, let's see a question of a line graph. The question says that the train runs through the cities A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. And the line graph indicates the time schedule of the train, including the time of arrival and the time of departure, which is represented by A, small a and small d, and the cities are represented by capital A, B, C and D. So in x-axis the information of time is given, starting from 7 a.m. to 6:25 p.m. as 18:25 is written there, 24-hour clock is used. And in the y-axis the distance covered by the train is given in terms of kilometer, starting from 0 up to 900 kilometers. Okay, let's see the first question of this type of questions. The question is, if the overall average speed of the entire trip, what is the overall average speed of the entire trip excluding stoppages, time nearly, you have to find the near time to this question. So let's see the thing. In the graph it is clearly mentioned that the total distance covered by the train is 860 kilometer. So total distance covered by train is 860 kilometer, and it is asking about the time excluding the stoppage. So time excluding the stoppage, that means the total time, as you can see that we start from 7 a.m. till 6:25 p.m. or 18:25. So total time comes out to be 11 hours 25 minutes. This is the total time of the train to start from the station A till the station H and so on up to the last point. This is the total distance covered by the train to for this much of the time. Okay, let's see the time excluding the stoppage. So how many stoppages are there, just count. First stoppage and is from B to C, between there is a one stoppage. So let's see the thing, the total time of the stoppage will be, so stoppage time, first part it is clearly mentioned that the first stoppage is from 8:40 to 8:50, that is of 10 minute. Next stoppage is of 10:10 to 10:12, it is of 2 minute. Next stoppage is of 11:55 till 12 o'clock, that means a 5 minute. In the similar way, rest of the stoppages are is of 10 minute, then a 15 minute, then again 10 minute. And the addition of all of these comes out to be 52 minutes. Addition of all of these comes out to be 52 minutes. So when you subtract 52 from this number, the time comes out to be 10 hours 33 minutes. When you exclude 52 minutes from this number, the time comes out to be 10 hours 33 minutes. Okay, let's see the thing. So this much distance is covered in this much time, so that means the speed comes out to be distance by time, and distance is 860 kilometer divided by the time. Time is 10 hour plus 33 minutes. We have to convert that minute into hours. So 33 divided by 60. So from here the value comes out to be 860 divided by 633, and the 60 will goes there. So when we are solving this whole value, we are getting an approximate value of 81 kilometer per hour. So this was the average speed of the train excluding the stoppages. Okay, let's see the another question. Okay, next question says that what percent of the time of the entire trip was actually spent traveling between the cities. So as we have previously discussed that the total time taken was 11 hour 25 minutes. Total time taken is 11 hour 25 minutes. This was the total time taken by the train. If we exclude the time taken by the train in stoppages, so stoppages time comes out to be 52 minutes. So when you subtract 52 minutes from this number, we'll getting a minutes. So minutes comes out to be 633 minutes, and it's asking about what percent of this one is of the total minutes. So total minutes 11 hour, convert 11 hour into minutes. So 11 hour, 11 into 60, 6600 plus 25, that means this will comes out to be 865 minutes. So total time is this one, and excluding the stoppage time was 633 minutes. So in terms of percentages, value comes out to be 633 divided by 685 and multiply by 104 percentage. So from here, we are solving the value, we are getting a value of 92.40, which is approximately equal to 92%. So our answer will be 92%. Okay, let's see another type of question. The another question of the same line graph is this: if the total stoppage time at the city in the first half and the second half of the city distinguished in the ratio is, in what ratio they are in the first half and the second half? As you can see that the total stoppages is of 6. So first half stoppages are 10 minutes plus 2 minutes plus 5 minutes, and the ratio, this one is your first half and this one is your second half, and second half ratio was 10 plus 15 plus 10. So from here the value comes out to be 17, and from here the value comes out to be 35, and this one is approximately double of this number. That means you can say that the approximate ratio comes out to be 1:2. Okay, let's see another question of same line graph. What does the question says? Question says that in between how many pair of consecutive stations does the train run below the overall average speed of the entire train? As we have already calculated, the overall average of the entire train speed was 81 km per hour. In question number 1 we have calculated this. Now in this type of question again we have to calculate the speed of every station, that means from station A to station B. What was the distance between station A to station B? The distance is 140 km, and the time taken, we converting the time taken is into minutes to into hours, that means the ratio comes out to be 5 divided by 3. So from here the speed of A to B station comes out to be 84 km per hour. Similarly for station B to station C, the total distance is, station B to station C, the total distance is 91. As you can see that in the graph, total distance is 91, and divided by the time taken by them, the time taken in terms of ratio comes out to be 4 divided by 3, so 3 will go here. So when you are solving this value, you are getting a value of 68.25 km per hour. Similarly go to C to D, the distance between C to D is 149, and divided by again in terms of ratio speed, which comes out to be 103 multiplied by 60, and we are solving this over value, we are getting a value of 86.79 km per hour. Similarly we go to the station D to station E, the average speed comes out to be, as you can see that the graph, the distance between D and E is 88 km, and divided by the time interval in terms of the hours, the time interval is 4 divided by 3, so 3 will go here. So from here the time speed comes out to be from D to E is 66 km per hour. Similarly the C, E to F, the speed comes out to be, the total distance was 106, and divided by the time, time in terms of r comes out to be 5/4. So when you are solving this value, we are getting a value of 84.8 km/h. Let's see, find out the another station, that means from F to G. From F to G, the speed comes out to be distance between F and G is 176 and time taken is 2 hours, so divided by 2. So from here the speed comes out to be 88 km/h. Let's move to the another one. Another one is from G to H. G to H, the total distance between G to H is 110 km, and divided by the speed in terms of the hour, the speed comes out to be 5/4. So 5/4 will go here. So from here the speed comes out to be 88 km/h. As you can see that the average speed was 81 km/h. And then you can see that how many numbers are there whose speed is less than 81 km/h. It is from station B to C. This one is 68.25 km/h. Next one is from station D to E. It is 66 km/h, again less than, and rest of the numbers are more than this speed. So our answer comes out to be 2. So there are 2 stations when the speed of the train is less than the average speed of the entire trip. Okay, see the next question of the line graph. The question says that the following line graph shows the percent of profit of company A, income of company B and expenditure of company B from 2006 to 2011, and the x-axis is representing the years and y-axis is representing the values. As you can see that there are 3 values are given, that means the triangle is representing the expenditure of B in rupees lakh. Next part, the circle is representing the percentage of profit of A, and next part, a square is representing income of B in lakh rupees. So this was the information is given. Let's see the question. Question number 1 says that what is the difference between the percent profit of company A and company B in the year 2006. So first of all, in 2006, this was the 2006, A is representing the circle. The circle value is in 2006 is 40%, that means A's profit percent is 40%. A's profit percent is 40%. And next part, in terms of B, is talking about B. In terms of B, B's value is, the income of B is 48.6. That means the income of B is 48.6 and expenditure of B was 36. So from here the profit for B comes out to be income minus expenditure, that will be profit, that is 48.6 minus 36, the value comes out to be 12.6. This was the profit for B. You have to calculate the profit percent of B. So profit percent of B comes out to be profit, that is 12.6 divided by the income. Income of B is 48.6 and multiply by 104%. So when you are solving this value, we are getting the approximate value of 26%. This one is your approximate value, comes out to be 26%. And the portion is difference between the profit percent of A and the profit percent of B. This one is profit percent of A. The difference comes out to be PA minus PB. The value comes out to be 40 minus 26. This will give you a 14%. So our answer will be 14%. Let's see another question. Another question says that if the income of company A in the year 2007 was 32.5 lakh. Let's see the income of company A in the year 2007. Just see the value in the graphs. In 2007, the profit percent of A is given, which is what? 25%. So profit percent of A is 25%, and the income of A is given, which is 32.5 lakhs. So next part of the question is, the question says that if the income of company A in the 2007 was 32.5 lakh, what was the sum of the net profit? So from here the profit of A will be 32.5 multiplied by 25%, which is 1 by 4. So from here the value comes out to be 8.125 rupees, lakh rupees. This was the profit of company A in terms of lakh. And in company B, the profit comes out to be, profit comes out to be income of company B minus expenditure of company B. So in 2007, the income of company B, as you can see that the graph, it was 35 minus the expenditure value is 25. So from here the value comes out to be 10 lakh and is asking about the net profit. So net profit will be 8.12 plus 10 lakh rupees. So net profit comes out to be, net profit comes out to be 10 plus 8.125, which is 18.125 lakh rupees. So that will be our answer. Okay, let's see another question. Another question says that if the expenditure of company A in 2010 was 45 lakh rupees, then the net profit of company A is what percent of the net profit in company B in 2010? Okay, let's see again. The expenditure of company A is given, expenditure of company A is given, which is nothing but a 45 lakh in 2010. In 2010, so in 2010, the profit percent of company A is given, which is 10%. So profit percent of company A is given, which is 10%. So when, as you can know, the profit percent will be is always equal to profit percent, right? This value in terms of correction. So in terms of correction, 10% will be written as 1 by 10. That means 10 is your income, 1 is your profit. And if 10 is your income, 1 is your profit, so expenditure will be income minus the profit, that will be 9. And the value of 9 is given in the question, which is 45 lakh rupees. So from here the value of 1 comes out to be 5 lakh rupees. And we have to calculate the profit percent. So profit value is 1. So 1 value is 5. That means the profit comes out to be, profit for A was 5 lakh rupees. And the next part of the question is, you have to calculate the net profit of company A is what percent of net profit in company B. So for company B in 2010, the net profit will be income of company B minus the expenditure of company B. So in 2010, income of company A, B was 80, expenditure for company B was 50. So difference comes out to be 30 lakh rupees, and you have to calculate the percentage. That means this is how much percent of this number. That means 5 divided by 30 multiplied by 100, 1 by 6, which is comes out to be 16.66%. So our answer will be 16.66%. Okay, let's see another question. Question of two mixture, two graphs. Mixture is this one. One is your bar graph, another one is your line graph. Let's see the question. The question says that the following bar graph shows the total number of people of different cities, and the line graph shows that the percentage of population and the percentage of male population below poverty line respectively. So two graphs are there. Just see your question number one. The question number one says that what is the average male population of all the six cities together. So average male population of all the six cities together is this one. In the bar graph, it is representing the population, the total population. In line graph, this is representing the population of male by a triangle. So let's see the average male population. So for first one, for city A, its value will be the 46% of 75. From here the value is coming out to be 34.5. From here the value is coming out to be 34.5. Okay, let's see for city B. Okay, for city B, the male population is represented by again triangle, it was 50%, that means of 50% of the total population of city B was 85. Total population of city B was 85. So that means from here the values comes out to be 42.5. Let's see for C. For C, the population of male given in terms of percentage was 60%. That means we have to calculate the value of 60% of 60. Okay, so 60% of 60, the value comes out to be 36. For city D, the percentage of male population is given, which is 40%. So 40% of the total population of city D, the total population of city D was 90. So from here, the value comes out to be 36. Again, for city E, the male population is 45%. Male population is 45%, which is of triangle. Again, 45% of the total population of city E was 50. So that means the half of this number, so half of this number comes out to be 22.5. Let's move to the city F. So for city F, the total population, male population comes out to be 60. Total population of male population comes out to be 55. So that means 55% of total population, which was 70. So from here the value comes out to be 38.5. And we are adding the value of 34.5, 42.5, 36, 36, 22.5, then 38.5. The total value comes out to be 210. And is asking about the average. So total cities are 6. So 210 divided by 6. From here the value is comes out to be 35 lakh. So our average answer comes out to be 35 lakh. Okay, let's see the question number second of the same problem. Question number second of the same chart is, what is the difference between the population below poverty line and the population above poverty line of the all the 6 cities? Okay, let's see. We are representing BP means below the poverty line. So for below the poverty line, it is given in the graph that the poverty line lies your square. Poverty line is represented by your square. So let's see the first one for B, for city A. It was 60% which are below poverty line. That means 60% of 75. That value comes out to be 45. In the same way, we are calculating the values of again the next one, which is a 40% of 85. The value comes out to be 34, and we are calculating the same values in so on. The values are coming out to be 27, 45, 35, and 42. And the addition of all of these comes out to be 228. And in the same way, the above poverty line, that value will be 60% or below poverty line. So above poverty line, it will be 40%. That means the 40% of 75, that will be 30. In the same way, if 40% for city B, 40% are below the poverty, so above poverty, that will be 60%. That means a 60% of 85, that will be 51, and so on. We are calculating the value. The values are coming out to be 33 plus next one is 45 plus the next one comes out to be 15 plus the next one is coming out to be 28. And the addition of all of this value comes out to be 202. And he's asking about the difference. So difference will be 228 minus 202. The value is coming out to be 26 lakh. This was your answer. Okay, so that's all for the day. Thank you very much.